We get comments like this all the time on our in-depth electrical installation videos, and we get it. There are a lot of terms that need to be understood before you ever cut a wire or pick up a wrench. Clearing up the confusion surrounding amps, watts, volts, and more is exactly what we're going to cover here in episode number one of this electrical terminology playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. What is a watt? Watts is a quantity of power. In other words, it's the amount of power required for something to function. For example, light bulbs are rated at a certain wattage. A 60-watt light bulb will ask for 60 watts from the power source to shine at its designated output. A larger load, like a space heater, is going to ask for much more power, potentially, let's say, 1200 watts for a standard space heater that you may plug into a normal wall outlet. So understanding that a watt is a quantity of power, there are three important ways that watts are used. Watts used to power a load, watts used as energy storage, and watts used to recharge a battery bank. So how are watts used to power loads? Watts used to power a load is going to be anything that uses power. Light bulbs, space heaters, computers, and I think you see where I'm going with this. Basically, anything that you plug in is going to use watts. How are watts used as energy storage? Watts used as energy storage is batteries. From rechargeable AA batteries to cell phones to the batteries in electric vehicles to the battery bank of a van, RV, or even off-grid house. They all store watts until a device asks for those watts to be able to run on. How are watts used to recharge batteries? Watts are used to recharge a battery bank. The most common example is going to be solar panels. The sun at any given time is putting off just a bit under 383 septillion watts of power. Now, we're not going to get into the how a solar panel works in this video, but all you need to know today is that we can harvest some of those watts with solar panels to recharge a battery. And every solar panel has a specific power rating of how many watts it can harvest at any given time, which is mostly based on how large or small the footprint of the solar panel actually is. In other words, a 500-watt solar panel will be roughly 5 times the size of a 100-watt solar panel, and each one will recharge a battery at those listed rates under perfect conditions. Now that you understand watts, let's immediately jump into watt hours, because they operate hand in hand. What is a watt hour? Once you understand a watt hour is easy to understand, and it's simply the rate at which watts are used, gained, or stored, similar to miles per gallon or kilometers per liter for fuel mileage, beats per minute in music, or dollars per hour when it comes to doing work and getting paid for it. Now, how do watt hours relate to electrical loads? Here's some easy examples of how watt hours are calculated. If you have a 100-watt light bulb and it's on for 1 hour, you have used 100 watts for an hour, which is 100 watt hours. If you've got a 100-watt light bulb and it's on for 2 hours, you have used 100 watts for 2 hours, which is 200 watt hours. If you've got a 100-watt light bulb running for 30 minutes, that's half an hour, which means that we've used 100 watts for a half hour, which is 50 watt hours. How do watt hours relate to power storage? Now, if you have a battery rated for 1200 watt hours, you have 1200 watts stored in that battery ready for your use. Now, if you connect a 1200 watt load to your 1200 watt battery and run it for 1 hour, your battery is going to last for 1 hour because you've pulled out 1200 watts for an hour, aka 1200 watt hours. But on the flip side, if you run a 1 watt load, The battery is going to last for 1200 hours because you've pulled out 1 watt for 1200 hours, aka 1200 watt hours. Either way, in that battery, you have 1200 watt hours available for your use, regardless of how fast or slow you use it. How do watt hours relate to recharging batteries? Watt hours in recharging batteries is the exact same thing as watt hours powering a load, like we've already talked about, just in the opposite direction. So if you've got a 100 watt solar panel and it's producing power for 1 hour, you have generated 100 watt hours back into your battery. If you've got a 100 watt solar panel and it's producing power for 2 hours, you have generated 200 watt hours back into your battery. A 100 watt solar panel for 30 minutes, well, that's half an hour, which means that we've gained 100 watts for a half hour, which is 50 watt hours. Now, we will go more in depth on watt hours in a future video dedicated to it, complete with calculations and spreadsheets, but this is all you need to know for now and will set you up for success when we talk about power audits later in this academy, so consider subscribing. What are volts? Volts is the unit for how hard watts are being pushed. For example, a standard 12-volt battery is pushing its wattage at 12 volts, which relatively isn't very much. That's why I can just touch the positive and negative terminals of a 12-volt battery without much risk of being shocked. Now, if I were to stick my fingers into a 120-volt outlet, I would absolutely be shocked every single time. This is because the voltage is pushing much harder, so much so that the 120 volts are able to push the wattage all the way through my body, completing the circuit and shocking me. Now it's time for a side quest to talk about resistance. What are ohms? Ohms is simply the unit for measuring resistance in a circuit. Resistance in a circuit is based on what the circuit is made of. Copper wires, for example, depending on their thickness, have a resistance of about 1 ohm. My skin has a resistance of 10,000 ohms. Now, if I had just gotten out of the swimming pool and was soaking wet, my skin's resistance may be closer to 1,000 ohms. The less resistance a material has, the better it will be for flowing electricity, which is why we use copper as a common material to make wires for carrying electricity. The only metal that is better at carrying electricity is pure silver, which understandably becomes cost prohibitive to use as wire. Now, back to volts. How do volts relate to powering devices? Pretty much every device is set up to be operated at a particular voltage. Here in the USA, anything that plugs into a standard wall outlet is designed to operate at 120 volts, unless there's an inline converter that converts the 120 volts to the proper voltage to run the device. This is fortunate because that's a standardized voltage output across the entirety of the country, and every country will have its own standardized voltage at a wall outlet. Now, a lot of lower powered items around a van, RV, or boat are powered by 12 volt power. Now, there's a lot more to understanding voltage, but for now, as long as you just understand that volts is the unit for how hard watts are being pushed, you're going to be in good shape. And actually, before we move on, it's also worth noting that if you try to operate a device at too low of a voltage, like a 120 volt device from a 12 volt source, it's likely not going to work. But on the other hand, if you over voltage a device, it's going to break things. Now, before we move on, let's take a 10 second break. Grab a drink, blink a few times, do some stretches, but I wanted to give you a heads up that I've made a quiz that I'd love for you to take after watching this video. Write your score down in the comment section below so we can see how you did. Let's keep moving. What are amps? Now, amps are very similar to watts, but are just more specific. In order to find amps, we simply divide the operating wattage of a device by its operating voltage, which gives us its amperage. In other words, the amps are simply the wattage of a device with a secondary understanding of how hard those watts are being pushed by the operating voltage. Why are amps important? The main place that we use amps is when determining the wire size that needs to supply power to a device or an outlet. Every wire size has a specific amperage rating attached to it, and the bigger the wire, the more amps it can flow. If we are powering a 12-volt, 1200-watt load from a 12-volt battery, that's 100 amps. And if we're powering a 120-volt, 1200-watt load from a 120-volt wall outlet, that's only 10 amps. This is the same amount of watts, both delivered at different voltages, both requiring different sizes of wire. Now, we're going to cover wire sizing in a dedicated video about it during this academy, but this is one of the main reasons why amps are important. What is an amp hour? An amp hour is nearly the same concept as the watt hour that we've already discussed. It's simply the rate at which amps are used, gained, or stored. Why are amp hours important? Most batteries for off-grid electrical systems list their power storage as amp hours. If we know that we have a 100 amp hour 12 volt battery, this means that we can pull 100 amps from that battery for 1 hour, or 50 amps from that battery for 2 hours. The math on the concept of amp hours versus watt hours is exactly the same. Now, I already know that SparkyChuck764 is going to be yelling at me down in the comments section saying, "Well, I got my electrical engineering degree in 1746 and have been a licensed master chancellor electrical supreme for 75 years, and you didn't talk about how Pukert exponents and C ratings affect batteries." And that's correct, Chuck. I purposefully skipped over some of the more complicated concepts in regards to amp hours and battery drain in the spirit of keeping this video beginner friendly. So for everybody else, just understand there is more to know about these concepts, but we have to start somewhere, and we're going to build on these concepts later in this academy. But for now, this is all you need to know. What is AC and DC current? Well, AC current and DC current stand for alternating current and direct current. And all we need to know for basic understanding here is that they're effectively two flavors, if you will, of power. AC current comes out of inverters to power standard household devices like blenders and induction cooktops. And DC power comes from a battery and is more common for 12 volt devices like puck lights and USB outlets. Now, there are DC powered devices like our phones that have an AC to DC converter built right into the charger to convert them from one flavor of power to the other. These two types of currents are typically seen listed as VAC and VDC, or volts of alternating current, or volts of direct current. For example, there are both AC and DC air conditioners. So if for some reason you stumbled across an air conditioner and had no idea of what flavor of power it needed to run, you could look on the specification sticker and it would say 120 VAC, which would mean that it needs 120 volts of alternating current to run, which would mean that it would need to be behind a DC to AC inverter in an off-grid electrical system, which we're going to talk about inverters more in an upcoming video. Now, those are the main terms that I find useful when talking about off-grid electrical systems and are going to form the backbone of this academy. So be sure to bookmark this video and come back to it for a refresher when you need it. Also, don't forget to take the quiz and let me know your score down in the comment section below. Now, unfortunately, all of these terms really don't mean much unless we can actually apply them to something that we can use. So, in the next video, I'm going to teach you all about the basic parts and components of an electrical system like inverters, solar charge controllers, batteries, fuses, shunts, and a lot more so that we can start putting these concepts to use. So tap up here to watch, and I'll see you over there. Power audits later in this academy.
Are you asking me or telling me?
I was asking you. Power audits later in this academy, so consider subscribing. There.
Hey.
Hey. Lots of syllables there.